Let's talk about the matrix of a linear transformation. So suppose we have two vector spaces, V and W, and a linear transformation between them called T. We have a basis B given by vectors B1, B2, all the way up to Bn for the space V, and a basis C given by C1, C2, up to Cm for the vector space W. Now, basis B, using the coordinate map, gives us a linear transformation to Rn. And similarly, there's a linear transformation to Rm given by the coordinate map of basis C. And now I want to complete this diagram so that going across with T and then down with the coordinate mapping for C gives me the same thing as going down using the coordinate mapping for B and then across. So this map across is going to be a linear transformation from Rn to Rm. And so we've seen those can be described by multiplication by a m by n matrix. And what does this m by n matrix m have to satisfy? Well, if I take this vector x from v, compute its b coordinates, and then multiply by m, so that's going down along this beige map, then this is going to be the same as going across the top, evaluating t on x, and then down using the coordinate map on c. So I get m times the coordinate vector, the b coordinate vector of x, is equal to the c coordinate vector of tx. Now this matrix m is called the matrix for t relative to b and c. So what do we have? What we have is, if you have a linear transformation between two finite dimensional vector spaces, if you're willing to choose a basis for each of those vector spaces, then you can represent the map by multiplication by the matrix. And then that's this matrix that we call the matrix for T relative to B and C. Now, the first column of M, if you look at this formula, has to be the linear transformation applied to the first basis vector of B, and then you take the C coordinates. So T of B1, and then take C coordinates. Similarly, the second column is T of B2, and then you take the C coordinate vector for that. And you do that for each column of M. And so then the nth column is going to be T applied to the nth basis vector of B, and you take C coordinates. So let's take a look at a concrete example. Suppose we have a vector space V with basis B1, B2, B3. Well, basis W, a vector space W with basis D1, D2. Suppose T is a linear transformation from V to W that has these properties, that it sends B1, the first basis vector of B, sends that to 3d1 minus 5d2. And suppose T of B2 is negative d1 plus 6d2. And T of B3 is 4 times d2. Now let's try to find the matrix for T relative to these two bases. So I can compute the d coordinate vector of T of B1, and that's 3 minus 5. Similarly, the d coordinate vector of T of B2 is negative 1, 6, and the d coordinate vector of T of B3 is 0, 4. And so from the previous slide, I see that to compute the matrix for T relative to B and D, I just stack these vectors together as the columns of the matrix. And so I get the matrix for T relative to B and D is 3, negative 1, 0, minus 5, 6, 4. Okay, so we have this linear transformation T from V to W, and a basis B chosen for V, and a basis C chosen for space W. If V and W are equal, and the basis B is the same as this basis C, then we have a special notation for it, for this matrix M. It's called the B matrix for T, and we'll just denote it with square brackets around T, and then we subscript it with the basis name B. So for example, let's consider the transformation T from P2 to P2. These are polynomials of degree at most 2. And we fix our basis B to be 1t squared. Suppose the linear transformation sends a0 plus a1t plus a2t squared to 3a0 plus 5a0 minus 2a1 times t plus 4a1 plus a2 times t squared. Let's compute the B matrix for t. So just as before, we're going to have to compute t evaluated on the first basis vector, so that's t of 1, and we get 3 plus 5t, plugging in to the formula we're given for t, and then we want the b coordinate vector of that. And so the b coordinate vector is 3, 5, 0. And then we apply t to the second basis vector, so we compute t of little t. And again, plugging in, we'll see that that's minus 2t plus 4t squared. And the b coordinate vector is 0, minus 2, 4. And finally, we are computing t of little t squared. That's the third basis vector of b. And plugging into the formula, we see that that's just t squared. And so that we get the b coordinate vector is 0, 0, 1. Which means the B matrix for T is this 3x3 matrix here, 3, 0, 0, 5, negative 2, 0, 0, 4, 1. Now, suppose A and C are two square matrices that are similar, so n by n similar matrices. Then that means there's an invertible matrix P such that A is P, C, P inverse. Let B be the basis formed by the columns of P. Then C is the B matrix for the linear transformation X goes to A times X. And so what that says is multiplication by the matrix A looks like multiplication by the matrix C as long as you're willing to use B coordinates. So let's see this in the diagram. We have as our vector spaces Rn and Rn. Multiplication by A defines this linear transformation from Rn to Rn. We have map going down given by multiplication by P inverse, and a map going up given by multiplication by P. And this map across is multiplication by C. Right? And so X, if I multiply by A, it goes across the top to AX. Multiplying X by P inverse just gives me the B coordinate vector of X. Then if I take that B coordinate vector and multiply it by C, I get C times the B coordinate vector of X, but that's just the B coordinate vector of AX. And then multiplication by P sends that to A times X. And so if I call this multiplication by A the transformation T, what this is saying is the B matrix for T is just the matrix C. And so notice A is P, C, P inverse. And so if I wanted to just compute this B matrix for the transformation T, I just compute P inverse AP. So let's look at an example. Suppose A is this 2x2 matrix, 4, negative 9, 4, negative 8, and I have for my basis of R2, 3, 2, 2, 1. Let's find the B matrix of the transformation given by multiplication by A. So we let P equal the 3, 2, 2, 1, the matrix you get with the vectors in B as columns. If C is the B matrix of this transformation, then A is equal to PC P inverse, right? Which tells me P inverse AP is the matrix C that we're trying to compute. And so I have P and I want P inverse. The determinant of P is 3 minus 4, which is minus 1, which means I can use the formula for P inverse and get that P inverse is minus 1, 2, 2, minus 3. And then C is just the product P inverse AP. And I just do the matrix multiplication, and I'll get this matrix minus 2, 1, 0, minus 2. So it tells me that the B matrix is minus 2, 1, 0, minus 2. So final remark, if A is diagonalizable, then A can be written as P times D times P inverse for some diagonal matrix D and an invertible matrix P. That tells us that D, this diagonal matrix, is the B matrix for the transformation given by multiplication by A. So in other words, if I'm taking the transformation T of X is A times X, then in B coordinates, the B matrix of T is just the matrix, the diagonal matrix, D.